Here's a simple example of a Turing machine. I like to write down the transition function in form of a table. Sometimes you might see other representations of Turing machines, like state diagrams, but I will mostly stick to these table representations. So this particular Turing machine has three internal states and uses the standard tape alphabet. The Turing machine starts in state Q start. If it reads a zero in that state, it remains in that state, writes a zero, so it doesn't change the zero that it read, and then moves the head one cell to the right. On the other hand, if it reads a zero in that state, it will switch its internal state to Q odd. It will not change the one either, so it will replace the one with a new one, and it will move the head one cell to the right. If it encounters a blank symbol in the start state, then it moves to the end state and it writes a zero instead of the blank symbol and then stops. In the state Q odd, if the Turing machine reads a zero, it remains in the state Q odd, it replaces the zero with another zero, and it moves the head one cell to the right. If it reads a 1 in this state, it switches the state back to Q start, it writes a 1 and moves one cell to the right, and if it encounters a blank symbol, it will move to Q end and write a 1 instead of the blank symbol and stay where it is with its head. And of course, the Q end state, we don't need to specify what happens, because once the Turing machine enters this QN state, that is the terminating state, and so the computation does not continue. This Turing machine does something very simple. It returns 1 if the input contains an odd number of 1s, and returns 0 otherwise. Here's another example of a Turing machine using three internal states and the standard tape alphabet. From the state Q start, if we read a zero, we switch to state Q ref. And we write a 1 and we move the head one cell to the left. And if we are in Q start and read a 1, then we replace the 1 by a 0 and we move the head one cell to the right. And if we encounter a blank symbol in the internal state Q start, then we also move to Q ref and we write a 1 instead of the blank symbol and we move the head one cell to the left. Now for Q ref, we would stay in that state. If we read a 0, we would not change that 0 and we would move the head one cell to the left. If we read a 1, we would stay in the state as well and write a 1, so not change it, and move one cell to the left. And if we read a blank symbol, we enter the terminating state, Q end, and replace the blank symbol with the blank symbol, so we will not actually change it, and then move the head one cell to the right. Can you figure out what this Turing machine does? And when I ask this, I mean, can you describe in some concise way, on a higher level, what this Turing machine does? What does it compute? If you want to think about it for a little bit, then you should pause. Otherwise, I will now tell you the solution. This Turing machine increments a natural number which is encoded in binary with the least significant bit on the left. So with this encoding, it takes a number x as an input and it outputs x plus 1. Having the least significant bit on the left is maybe an encoding you have not seen as much before. And of course, we could also construct a Turing machine that would solve the same problem, but where the encoding would be in such a way that the least significant bit would be to the right. However, such a Turing machine would first need to go all the way to the right and then somehow perform the same actions as our machine here, but in a mirrored way. So this sort of shows that the new Turing machine would be a bit more inefficient. It would need to perform more computational steps. This is just a small illustration for the fact that the input and output encodings can matter. If you use different encodings, then the number of computational steps needed for your computation might change. So a lot of the time we gloss over the encoding, but sometimes it's actually important to pay attention to how the input and output is encoded.